Well, hello everybody, welcome back to another video from Exotic Astrology. After so many days, I have got time to upload a new video today. So finally, today is Tuesday. The nakshatra of Swati was operating, okay, and we will discuss about the most important planet in Vedic astrology, okay. Either you take it Vedic or you take it Western. This was, this is, and this will be the most important planet to be considered, okay? What do you see here? You see the moon, yes? The beautiful moon shining in its effulgence, brightness, grace, love, kindness, warmth. Yes, beautifully it is shining. Actually, it reflects the light of the sun, as we all know. It doesn't have its own light, yes? Okay. So, why is Moon considered to be the most important planet in Vedic astrology? It is known as Chandra in the Sanskrit texts, okay? Chandra refers to the Moon. And Moon is the closest planet to the Earth. Although, in modern day science, they do not consider Moon as a planet, but as I had already said in my earlier videos, we do not take the word planet as a literal translation for the word graha. Graha means that which captures you, that which puts grahan over you. Grahan means capturing. Okay. Now, what does graha capture? It captures your intelligence, because everything happens from the head. You decide to love somebody from the head, you decide to kill somebody from the head. You decide to apply for a job interview, or you decide to resign from the head. Everything is in and out from the head, okay? So, Moon is a planet. It is a graha, means it has power to capture us, okay? And what is the Moon? Moon is the planet which decides which nakshatra you will have, how the dasha system will start, okay? When I say nakshatra, I mean every planet will be in a zodiac sign, and within zodiacs there are nakshatras. Every zodiac has three nakshatras, okay? We will see what are nakshatras and how each nakshatra is placed in every zodiac sign later, okay? That is a topic of the future. But today we will see how Moon is actually determining almost everything that we go through on a daily basis, or what is happening to us, okay? Everything is decided by this planet, okay? Now, we had discussed about the planet Sun. What was the Sun? Sun is you, your inner self, your ego, okay? It is you, the person, your inside, your determination, your strength, your willpower, your ability to do things in life. Sun is the power in the chart. But how do you do those activities? Can you just do it out of any interest? No, you cannot do things which you do not like for a long time. Okay. Of course, you may do it mechanically. You may do it without having any interest, but there will be no quality there. Okay. So, Moon represents the emotions. Moon represents the mood. Moon is the mind. Okay. Now, mind also has a part of Mercury, because Mercury is also the intelligence, okay? Now, when we say Moon, it represents our emotions, your mood. As we say, today my mood is good, today my mood is bad, okay? And who is the significator of Moon? It is Chandra, the demigod, okay? And also among the incarnations of Lord Vishnu, Lord Krishna is the deity which is signifying or controlling this moon, okay? And Lord Ram is the one who controls the sun. Lord Ram signifies the sun. And Lord Krishna signifies the moon, okay? So, how moon affects us? See, you have to understand this. Moon is the closest planet. It is the closest to the earth. That means it has the power to affect all of us very strongly, okay? It is responsible for the tides in the oceans, in the seas, in the rivers, whatever you call it, in the water bodies, okay? It is responsible for the six kind of juices which the fruits, vegetables and eatables produce, okay? By which we get nourishment, because moon is the significator of mother, okay? It is ruling the original sign of Cancer, which is the fourth sign of the zodiac, which is the fourth house. Fourth house is what? Fourth house is luxury, happiness, comforts, delight, our sense of content, our sense of happiness, our sense of purpose, our sense of belonging, what we identify with. Yes, that is why they say home is where the heart is. Yes, you may be in your home, but if your mother is fighting with your father or your brother is not happy with you, you will not feel as if you are at home. On the other hand, you may be sitting in a forest meditating alone. If you find happiness there, that becomes your home. That means you have become a yogi. Okay. Now, there are 27 nakshatras. Okay, as per Vedic astrology, of course, there is another nakshatra which is known as Abhijit, but we will discuss about it later. Nakshatras are called lunar mansions. Okay. Now, I will tell you the story what of nakshatras actually. I will come to what nakshatras are actually in astrology later, but I will say the story now. There are 27 nakshatras and all these 27 are wives of the moon. Yes, he has 27 wives. Maybe he has more than 27. I do not know as of now how many, what is the exact number of his wives. But these 27 are definitely his wives. So, who are these 27 actually? These 27 are the daughters of Daksha Prajapati. Okay. Daksha Prajapati is a very interesting character in the Vedic scriptures. He had 27 daughters and he got them married, all of them, to Chandra. Okay. Chandra is moon. He is also known as Soma, because Soma refers to the semen which is there in our body. Okay, Soma also refers to the heavenly juice, heavenly delights, heavenly nectars. That is also referred to by as Soma. Okay. Now, Daksha Prajapati got all of them married to Soma. Okay. And then, what does moon do? Every day, roughly near about to 24 hours or a bit less than 24 hours, he will transit to every nakshatra. Okay, what is transit? Transit means he will travel. Okay, like for example, in today's date, 6th of June, Tuesday, sun is transiting in the sign of Taurus in Rohini nakshatra. Okay. Similarly, Rahu is in Magha Nakshatra now, in the sign of Leo. Okay, so every zodiac sign has subparts which are known as nakshatras. Okay, they actually give the flavor of the zodiac, that particular zodiac sign. For example, which is the starting nakshatra? Where if you want to know the starting nakshatra, you have to know the starting zodiac sign. So which is the starting zodiac sign? Yes, you guessed it right. It's Aries, right? Okay. So, Aries has three nakshatras. Every zodiac sign will have three nakshatras inside it. It is like there is a home. Inside the home, there's a kitchen, there's a drawing room, and then there's a bathroom. It is something like that. Of course, that does not mean that the third nakshatra is not good or the first nakshatra is good. I'm just giving an analogy to explain that they are parts of the same home. Okay. Or house, whatever you call it. And every nakshatra is 13 degree 20 minutes. Okay. So, the first nakshatra that comes in the sign of Aries is Ashwini. So, first 13 degree 20 minutes. Every zodiac sign is 30 degrees. And every nakshatra will be 13 degrees 20 minutes. And then the next nakshatra is Bharani. Okay, that is again 13 degree 20 minutes. So if you combine two, it becomes how much? 26 degree 40 minutes. 13 20 into 2, which is 26 40. And then the last last 3 degrees remain. Yes, last 3 degree, 20 minutes remain. If you subtract 26, 40 from 30, you will get 320. Yes, minutes actually, because 60 minutes will make 1 hour. So 40 minutes is gone, then 20 minutes is remaining. And the last 3 degree, 20 minutes is controlled by Kritika Nakshatra. That is under Kritika Nakshatra. Okay. And the remaining 10 degree of Kritika, because in Aries, as we have seen, only 3 degree 20 minutes is left, and every nakshatra is 13 degree 20 minutes. So the first quarter of the Kritika Nakshatra will fall in the sign of Aries, and then the remaining 3 quarters will fall in the sign of Taurus. So I will go into the detail of these nakshatras and what they are, what specifically they mean later, okay? But as of now, I am saying Moon needs exactly 27 days roughly to transit the whole zodiac belt, okay? These 27 nakshatras. And because every planet rules 3 nakshatras, so like that we have 9 planets. What are the 9 planets? The Sun, the Moon, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Mercury, Venus, Rahu, Ketu. So these are 9 planets, and each of them rules 3 nakshatras each. Okay, so you have 9 into 3, 27 nakshatras. Let me give you an example. As I said, Ashwini, Bharani, Kritika. This order will always remain same. Whenever I say any planet is in 10 degree Aries, you got to understand it is in Ashwini nakshatra. Okay, if a planet is in 28 degrees of Aries, it is in Kritika nakshatra. If a planet is in 19 degrees of Aries, it is in Bharani nakshatra. So similarly, these nakshatras are ruled by certain planets. Okay, every planet will rule 3 nakshatras. For example, Ashwini is ruled by Ketu, Bharani is ruled by Venus, and Kritika is ruled by Sun. Okay, so Moon, every day he will stay in one nakshatra, and then the next day he will go to the another nakshatra. Okay, so in 2.5 days Moon will transit one zodiac sign. Okay, and then he will go to the next zodiac sign. That is why the Moon is the fastest moving planet. Okay, and that is why our mind is also very fickle. Today our mind is in the traits of Swati nakshatra. Tomorrow it will be in some other nakshatra, then one day it will go to Rohini, and then one day it will go to Pushya, one day it will go to Uttar Falguni. Yes, so that is why every nakshatra has specific definite traits, okay, which is exclusive to that nakshatra itself, only that nakshatra. Even the other two nakshatras in the same zodiac sign, for example, Ashwini, Bharani, Kritika, Ashwini will have zero or very less similarities with Kritika and Bharani. Okay, similarly Kritika will not have any similarity between Ashwini, Bharani. Yes, so although Moon is in one sign for 2.5 days, but still it is changing nakshatras. Okay, one day it moves around 13 degree 20 minutes, then the other day again it will move 13 degree 20 minutes. Some roughly, I am just giving a rough estimate. That is why the moon is very fickle. Okay, mind is very fickle. That is why the mind always runs from here to there. Okay, that because Moon is moving very fast. Okay, and that is why our emotional fluctuation is also very dynamic. Our moods change very frequently. Okay, of course that will depend on the placement of Moon in the natal birth chart. Okay, if Moon is placed in difficult signs like Scorpio or Aquarius or Capricorn, then there can be more challenges to this Moon. Or if it is placed with Saturn or with Rahu or with Ketu, then there can be more difficulties. Okay, but if Moon is placed in Taurus, in Sagittarius, or in the sign of Pisces, okay, or even in Leo, or if it is with Sun, not with Sun, with Sun it does not do very good, but with Jupiter it does fabulous. with Venus also it does relatively good. With Mercury depends on the house and the sign. And with Mars also it does reasonably good. Now, if Moon is affected in a positive way, then it will do good. Okay. And if it is connected to other planets in a bad way, it will unfortunately do bad. Bad in the sense our mental fluctuations will be more. We will be more negative. We will be more positive if the Moon is well placed. Okay. Depending on the house and placements and signs, we will see that later. Okay. Now, basically what the Moon is the mind. Okay. Moon is your feelings, your ability to feel. As you are hearing this video, you are feeling something inside. You may be feeling good, you may be feeling bad, whatever it is. Or maybe something happened with you today. Your boss shouted on you. Or your wife made something very excellent for you in the morning, okay? Or maybe your birthday is coming after a week. So you are very excited. So that sense of happiness, joy, fulfillment, or sense of despair, unhappiness, discontent, all this is controlled by the Moon. That is why whichever nakshatra Moon was when you were born, that is called your birth nakshatra, birth star, okay? Janma nakshatra. That is the most important nakshatra in your whole horoscope. For example, if Moon is when you were born, okay, when you were born, suppose you were born on 1950 in Paris, okay, at 9 o'clock in the morning, okay. I'm just giving an example, any day, maybe 1st August, 2nd August, 3rd August, okay. Then Moon, suppose it was transiting the nakshatra of Pushya, which is considered to be the best of all the nakshatras, king of all nakshatras, the best, then it will, your mind, which is what you will have these traits of the Pushya nakshatra. What is Pushya nakshatra? It's growth, expansion, nourishment, welfare, social work, religion, spirituality, God, gurus, divine knowledge, divine encounters, massive, huge political entourage. All these great traits are there in the Pushya nakshatra. So you will have these traits very prominent. Okay. Now, your sun will be in some zodiac sign, in some nakshatra. Your Jupiter will also be in certain nakshatra, in some zodiac sign. Okay. Your Saturn will be in some sign. All those are also important. But the placement of Moon is the most important. Because you always go through some feeling or the other with whatever happens to you in this life. Okay. Suppose you decided to go to the gym, but then due to some reason you could not continue. It may not affect other areas much, okay, but it will affect your mood. You may feel that, oh, I could not keep up with my resolution. So you will feel a bit bad inside. Ideally you should feel bad if some commitment you break it. Or you might feel very good if you start going to the gym again. So your going to the gym may or may not have a direct impact on your career, which is signified by Saturn, Sun, Mercury, etc. Okay, but that will have some effect at least on yourself. Okay, I'm not talking of the physical burning of the calorie, but your internal side, you will feel good maybe, or you may feel a bit bad. Okay, so that is why it is very important. And Moon is the mind, okay. And the mind always looks for different things for enjoyment. It is never satisfied. That is one difficulty. That is one challenge with the Moon, okay. Suppose Moon is placed in the sign of Sagittarius. The person will be very spiritual by nature. He may not be into too many spiritual activities. That will depend on the overall horoscope. Okay. If the planets are saying that we will allow him to practice spirituality. Okay. Or if at all the person is spiritual, then he will take birth in a time when the planetary alignments are such. But the point is, if his Moon is in Sagittarius, then he will have a very philosophical outlook towards life. He will be a follower of God. Okay. or particularly the religious tradition in which he is, okay, or his mother can be like that. Now see, sun moon represent the personality, okay, and the mother father also, because that is how the genes come now. Yes, so that is why when earlier days in India the child was in the womb of the mother, when the mother was pregnant, after it was declared after 3 months that she is pregnant, she for the rest 6 months till the birth of the child of the ninth month, she used to stay in the home, and she used to the holy men used to come and they used to read the scriptures, the Ramayana, the Mahabharat, okay, the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Gita, the Puranas, the Vedas, the Upanishads. So that when the mother keeps hearing about God and spirituality, divine topics, divine enlightenment, the son also gets benefited. Because whatever, however the mother is, that is how the son will also be. However the mother father is, because the sun moon determines the person, and sun moon is what? The father and the mother. Okay, so the sun moon are very important. Okay, so similarly, we also know that moon represents the comforts, luxuries. Now see, happiness comes from the mother. Father is always very strict. The son is always strict. Okay. Father will never smile at you. He may sometimes. But he will always ask you, what you are doing? Have you finished your exam? Have you got a job? Have you done this? Have you done that? Okay. Why have you not done this? Why? When will you do this? Do it, do it, do it, do it, do it. Because son is responsibility. Responsibility is Saturn, but son also shows your commitment. Okay. Your ability to be fixed. Okay, go forward, carry ahead. So the moon is very soft, it's very calm, and it's very soothing. Can you see the sun in the afternoon? My God, your eyes will be burnt. You can't stare at the sun for long. It's too much of light, too much heat, too much energy. But have you seen the beautiful moon in a full moon night? So beautiful it is, right? It looks so beautiful. And when the moon is with the sun, it is known as Amavasya or complete darkness. Okay, that means the person, he himself and his mind, the mind cannot see the person. You understand? So that means Amavasya shows people who are born in confusion. They lack a direction in life. People who are born in Amavasya, because sun and moon are sitting together, the mind cannot see the person, because sun is a very hot object. Anything which is in contact with the sun gets burnt. It is called combust. So when moon sits with the sun, moon only gets combust. So that means that the person's mind itself is not existing. It is like the mind does not exist. So these people can lack emotions at times. Or they can lack more than emotions. They may not lack emotions. They may lack emotional fulfillment in life. They may be insensitive towards others, because moon is sensitivity. It's that feminine energy which is very loving and caring and considerate towards others. Because moon also represents social service. It represents the public. Okay. It signifies the fourth house of homeland. Homeland is the public. That is why elections are also seen from the fourth house. Okay. I will not go into elections now, but what I am trying to say here is moon has definite importance, okay, specific importance, and it's very prominent. You cannot ignore the moon. There is this one placement which can change the whole game. All the planets are badly placed, but if moon is well placed, it can change the game. All the planets are well placed, but your moon is badly placed, it can create mayhem inside you. Because if all other planets are good, you may get a lot of good opportunities externally. But if your mind is not good, your mind is not stable, it's not happy, it's not able to enjoy fulfillment, then what? Then you cannot utilize those things now, which is coming externally to you. then ultimately you will suffer. But suppose all the other planets are not well placed, but the moon is very well placed, then that shows a person that whatever happens in his life, he will take everything positively and take it as a stepping stone towards the next ladder of success which he climbs. So that is why this one planet is given so much importance. Number one, because it is the closest to the earth, so its impact, we feel it the maximum. So as I said regarding that gym example, it may not affect your career or even your body, but it will affect your heart very much. Some money you lose, you will feel very bad inside. I lost this money. You gain some money, you will feel very happy. See, happiness, comfort, sense of fulfillment, all this is moon, and moon is the mind. And moon does fabulous in the sign of Taurus. It gets exalted there in 3 degrees of Taurus, which is in Kritika Nakshatra, second phase of the Kritika Nakshatra. We will discuss about exaltation later. Exaltation means the sign where a planet gives the best results. Of course, there are various other factors to be considered. And the opposite of Taurus is its debilitation, which means the very poor performance, very pitiable condition of the planet, moon in Scorpio. Why Scorpio is a difficult sign for the moon? Because Scorpio is co-ruled by Ketu. Scorpio is ruled by Mars and Ketu, two planets, remember. Not only Mars, it is ruled by Mars and Ketu. Before Scorpio, let me explain about Taurus. Taurus is what? It is the earth sign. It represents family, it represents food, it represents security. Security and gathering and accumulation of substances, wealth, relationships, money. This is the sign of Taurus. So your mind always likes to delight in family and accumulation of wealth. You always see, you will always feel, oh, this shirt I had 10 years back, I'll still keep this with myself. You don't want to give things away. Whenever somebody steals something from you, you feel very bad. So that is why in Taurus, when there is a lot of stability, security in that sign. So whenever moon is placed, that means he will get very less situations in his life where he will be stripped of the things which he loves. Okay. That is why his moon will naturally be stable. Okay. His mind will naturally be stable. Okay. But if it is in the sign of Scorpio, which is directly opposite to Taurus, which is co-ruled by Ketu and Mars, Ketu is energy which sucks away things from you. So if your moon is in Scorpio, life can give you situations at times when you can realize that the things which I love the most, they have been taken away from me. It can be people, it can be money, it can be wealth, family, anything, any family assets or anything. Yes. So that is why moon gets debilitated in the sign of Scorpio, because it cannot tolerate going through pain, separation basically. That is the most painful thing for the mind, because it always wants to keep and accumulate. Apart from that, it does good in the sign of Cancer also, relatively well, because it is its own sign. And it does good in Pisces and signs like Sagittarius and Leo also. And in the signs ruled by Saturn, it may not do that great. Okay. So that's it from my side. Moon is the most important planet because it is your mood. It is where you are. Okay. If you have any questions, queries, then please leave it in the comments, and you can subscribe to my channel and click in the bell for the notifications. Otherwise, you will miss the videos and you will not come to know that I am uploading. Okay. So that's it from my side. Bye bye. See you. Take care.